Welcome to another episode of The Doubleheader, where we talk about the politics of sport and the sport of politics, and sometimes even more. I'm here with syndicated columnist Mark Shields and New York Times syndicated columnist. Are you really syndicated?
No. The whole Times is syndicated.
The whole Times is syndicated. That's why I see you on like these random small sites and all over the world. David Brooks. So, you guys have both talked in different ways about super PACs. You're not talking about this on the broadcast tonight. I think you had a column this week on it, and I think Bill Maher decided to throw in $1 million for Obama. What was it, Jeffrey Katzenberg, $2 million, the SEIU. Is this good? Is this just painting into the, oh, look at the liberals and Hollywood connection and these millionaires supporting Obama versus the super PACs that might be supporting Romney or whichever candidate they were hoping to field?
Oh, I think it's good. I mean, if you get more money into politics, especially big money from the people. I mean, God shows how little concern she has for money, the people she gives it to, if you look at it. I mean, just go right through it in life. I mean, there is nothing that is more harmful, noxious, and pernicious to our politics than the Supreme Court decision that has opened the floodgates of this money. I mean, it truly is. It skewers the entire process. I mean, one person can just keep a candidate alive, indifferent to the voters' reactions or sentiments. But more than that, anything else, it's secret in most cases, in many cases. And it's just, it's unhealthy. I mean, you're talking and you become a supplicant to people that, who really are a strange breed of animal.
So he's clearly, not cutting to the chase here.
Yeah, well, I guess I have numerous thoughts. One, I generally agree it's bad. Citizen United has been bad for democracy. Two, I don't think somebody with a lot of money can create a candidate. You can't buy an election. I generally don't think so.
Now, Peter Thiel,
at a national level,
for example, the cajillionaire is throwing a lot of money behind Ron Paul for the next cycle.
Right, but if Ron Paul didn't have a natural following, Peter Thiel's money wouldn't do much good. And I don't think Sheldon Adelson is going to put Newt Gingrich over the top. The Bill Maher thing is interesting, which upsets him. The Bill Maher thing is, I mean, he's nominally a commentator.
Yeah.
To me, it's a complete violation of ethics to do this. I think HBO should relieve him. But the final thought I have is, you got $1 million. You can do a lot of good. You could give a bunch of kids scholarships. You can do an early childhood education program. You're going to give it for negative ads? It's unfathomable to me. I would spend my money that way. So it's always a lot.
Okay. And then since we've got a lot of non-serious business to get to today, the politics of sport. National League MVP, Ryan Braun, the first player to challenge the drug testing policy of the Major League Baseball system and come out ahead. What do you think? Did he take it? Did he not? Is he getting off on a technicality?
I don't know if he took it. I mean, something came up in the test, but I think the key phrase you used was most valuable player. If he had been a utility infielder with Cincinnati, would it have gotten the same kind of attention and maybe presumption of innocence? I don't know. But it tells you there's something wrong with the testing system that's being used.
The courier took it home, put it in the fridge for a few days. That's kind of a problem.
Yeah.
I confess there's a little ethnic pride here. I don't know if he's the first Jew to win the MVP prize, but he's a Jewish MVP winner.
I did not know he was Jewish. Jewish named Ryan.
Sandy Koufax, did he win? Hank Greenberg?
He didn't think the FedEx worked on the weekends, right? That was
Think pitchers won it when Sandy Koufax. It was a player in it.
Oh, right.
I guess pitchers did. He certainly should have won.
And then what you have in your hands right now would be a filled-out Oscar ballot by Mark Shields, David Brooks, and myself. They are going into these envelopes right here. They will be hermetically sealed and placed on a jar.
And a Hellman's mayonnaise.
Hellman's mayonnaise.
And I should say that twice in my career, I've been a movie critic.
Yes.
And I am not good at telling people what they should like, but I'm really good at picking the winners.
The winners?
Are you really?
I know rich, old Academy types.
And they are.
I know the median age
is like 63.
Really? 163, actually.
Yeah. Is it really?
So it's now, not that this is
not who
you
want to win. Can you tell us what
you
chose as the movie?
No, not yet. Well, I guess we'll come back. You guys are traveling. There's some travel stuff going on.
The movie is not the controversial one. That's obvious.
You think
really?
The artist?
Obvious?
Yeah. Are you really?
Is what? The artist?
Yeah.
Dang.
Okay. All right. Well, he's leaking some. All right. Yeah. We're going to get to these when we come back after our different hiatus and stuff. And also, you guys got an award this week. The Civility Award.
What's it do you?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yeah, right. And I have to go ahead.
Disagree.
And, I have to disagree. Agreeably. This is for your participation in the News Hour. You'll talk about this on the program as well, but this was from Allegheny College, is that right?
Mm-hmm. It's a fine school. And, very old school near Pittsburgh.
Now, I just want to say that from all of the years that they could have selected you, the fact is that it happens the first year after you start doing the doubleheader.
Yeah, that's true.
Boy. I'm just saying.
It was a barrier they had overcome.
But
anyway,
everybody is flawed.
Everyone. Yeah. But thank you again for your participation in this and on the program. And I think the reason that people like you on the program and even online here is just because that you disagree agreeably and you keep things civil. And I think that that's very important for us and for the country. So thanks for
thank you, Harry.
All right, that. Says it all. This is another episode of the Double. I was like, wait a minute, that's getting all right. Yeah. That's the.
That's getting sort of sentimental. Lifetime achievement. Yeah, the Irving Thalberg Award.
Thank you for watching, and join us again when we will unveil the actual winners versus what our predictions were for the best movie, the best actor, the best actress, and the best director. Thanks for joining us.